Hi everyone and welcome to this new ToonMotion tutorial. In today's video, we'll be looking at the new spacing tool. You can find it by clicking on the populate icon at the bottom of the screen, head over to place, spacing. The spacing tool allows you to place assets on a spline. So here, in the first example I want to do, let's actually recreate those dash markings that we can see on the ground. Those are by default present in that automotive template that I'm using for this presentation. So let's first select them and hide them so we can recreate those. We'll come back to populate, spacing, I will click on my pen and I will start to create a spline roughly in the middle of my road. Once I'm happy with my spline, I can right-click on my mouse to unselect it, so I can now start to edit it. I will click on this icon here to see more options and expand the property panel on the left of the scene organizer. So now we have all the options regarding the spline. So we can play with the spline tension, so we have something really smooth. And now, to better see what we are doing, let's add a decal. I will come to the object library, decal, and I will use here that single dash marking. As you can see here, by default, this one is turned 90 degrees. So we'll select the object in my Dropbox here, and on the settings per object, I can change the rotation. Let's collapse all the settings to see all the options available on this tool. So first you have the settings of the selected object. So here we are selecting a decal. So we have all the options regarding the decal. We can play with the size, the color, the opacity. That's the exact same option when you drag and drop the asset manually in your scene. Like here we can see all the exact same settings. Below that, you will find all the options regarding the tool. Here now, what I want to do is just increase the count. And after that, you have the settings of that object inside the tool. Obviously here, I'm pretty happy with the base settings. I just want to change a bit the opacity so it blends a bit better with my road. So I'm coming back to the asset properties. I'm going to change the opacity. Let's try on another example. I will come back to the populate. I will pick my pen again. And here I'm just going to scatter some streetlight. So I create my spline, just changing the spline tension so it's smooth. I will come to the city, streetlight. I'm going to use, let's say, this one. This one actually is already perfectly oriented with the lights overing the road. But if I wanted to change that, same idea here. I will select the mesh. Here it will give me the option and I can change the rotation. You need to release the slider for the settings to be applied. It's not done in real time. Let's say now if I'm adding a new object to that Dropbox. Let's say I want to add maybe some bollard. Let's add this one so we can really see it with that yellow that will be a bit more visible. So here, when you add multiple objects, it will scatter one at a time. So you will always have that streetlight, then you will have the bollard and come back to the streetlight. You can add any number of assets in that Dropbox. And you can play here with the count to have more or less of them. It also works for vegetation. So let's come back to the populate. I will create a new spline here. Let's shift it a bit away from the road so we can play with some of the scattering settings. So now that I created that spline, I will come to the library, vegetation, trees. I'm going to drag and drop some trees. So let's start here with that Austrian pine and maybe that Northwest spruce. So here, again, the settings by default, we always have one Austrian pine, then one Northwest spruce. So now I want more density. As you can see here, by default, it aligns to the geometry. So here it places the object on top of each of those rocks. So it's actually pretty cool. That's what I want. I can also disable that if I want the object to be placed exactly on the spline and not following the terrain. Right now we can see the repetition here because by default there is not a random rotation. So let's do a couple of settings. So first I want to have some lateral offset. So if I'm moving the camera up, here you can see we have a straight line and the assets are just placed on that line. If I'm changing here the lateral offset, it gives more freedom for the object to be placed. Now let's select all the two assets here. I'm going to give a random rotation here, so it gives some more randomness. Here, if I'm selecting the align option, each object on the drop box will be aligned on the geometry it is applied on. And for the tree, it's not exactly what I want. I want all my tree to grow straight. So we'll leave that option disabled. But if I'm placing some grass, that will be perfect because the grass should follow the slope of the terrain. I want to have a bit more density, so I'm just going to raise again the count. So I'm pretty happy with that result. So let's now select the spline, the spacing tool here in my scene organizer. What I want to do is have the same spacing tool, but in my inner circle here. So I'm going to duplicate the spline. I'm going to just shift it a bit so it follows the spline nicely above here. And now I'm just going to select back the point and move them. And that's it for this video. Thanks everyone for watching it, and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone.